I'm Dr. Nitin Tawte, General and Laparoscopic Surgeon from Terna Speciality Hospital, Nerul, Navi, Mumbai. Today I'm going to be showing you a case of a 2-year-old boy who presented with mesenteric cyst of 5 cm who hailed from Iraq. He presented to us with acute abdominal pain on and off since the last 2 months. This procedure is started with the opening up of the capsule. Now, as you can see, the capsule is being held and the cyst is being dissected from inside the capsule. The cyst is being dissected completely so that we don't injure the cyst wall and there is no spillage of contents into the peritoneal cavity. Now, the cyst wall may have some amount of blood vessels which need to be cauterized and they need to be tackled accordingly so that there is no bleeding. Now, as you can see, with the instrument we are trying to dissect of the cyst completely without injuring the cyst wall. Now, cyst, the outer capsule is being separated completely so that the cyst can be dissected out of that cyst wall. Now, this patient came with acute abdominal pain on and off. Patient had gone to some other hospital and he was told about an open surgery which we told him we could very well manage it laparoscopically. So this patient came to us, he had shown us the films earlier. Over the mail we discussed a few issues because he hailed from an outside country, and after seeing the films we decided we can do the whole thing laparoscopically with the help of 3 small tiny 5 mm incisions in his abdomen. So now, as you can see, all the vascular adhesions to the cyst are being released, they are being cauterized so that there is no bleeding. So we put 3 5 mm ports in him. The first port was a camera port which was put in the epigastrium. The second 5 mm port was put in the left lumbar region. And the third port was put in the right lumbar region. So this, as you can see, all the vascular adhesions are being released. The advantage of laparoscopic surgery is that we are having very small incisions which are carved out in the abdominal wall. There is not much of muscle damage. The recovery of the patient is good. The patient can be started on orals very early. The amount of painkillers which are required for the patient is also very less. The patient normally in such surgeries is put on full orals after 3 hours. Liquids are started after 2 hours. And after 3 to 4 hours, the patient goes on full oral diet. So now you can see all the adhesions, the vascular adhesions. The adhesions which contain the blood vessels are being cauterized so that there is no bleeding and the cyst is slowly separated from its capsule. We have to see that we avoid injury to the adjacent intestines. You can see the adjacent intestines and the blood vessels. So we have to take care not to injure any blood vessels. So that is why we use all these blunt instruments so that there is no injury to the other structures. Now this is a major pedicle which is there, which we need to separate so that we can get hold of the bowl of the cyst wall. So slowly the adhesions are being released. All the intestines are in its vicinity, so they needs to be taken care of. This laparoscopic surgery is done by these instruments which are very delicate and 5 mm incisions so that we avoid too much of tissue damage. Now as you can see, this is the other major blood vessel which is attached to the cyst which we need to tackle so that we have an adequate control of the blood vessels so that there is no bleeding. This blood vessel will be cauterized and taken care of by cauterization so that there is no bleeding. The cyst wall is slowly being separated by taking care of these blood vessels. Now you can see only a few attachments are remaining. Most of the attachments on the anterior surface and the superior surface have been tackled. Now only the posterior main surface is remaining, which normally contains the blood vessels running across. So they have to be tackled so that there is no injury to the intestinal blood vessels, and only the vessels which are supplying the mesenteric cyst are tackled. So this requires adequate precision so that all the intestines are taken care of, and the blood vessels only going to the cyst are tackled. Now these are the other small vessels which are being held and cauterized. At the same time, we need to ensure that there is no injury to the other adjacent intestines. The metallic part of the instrument needs to be in the view at all times so that the cautery current is not spread to the rest of the organs in its vicinity. So now once we have cauterized it, we are just dissecting it by the help of the scissors so that the vessels fall apart, they are separated from the cyst wall, and the cyst wall comes apart, separate from the blood vessels. So this is the advantage of laparoscopic surgery. Now this is a hook which is used so that the blood vessels again are cauterized. The advantage of the hook is that the whole instrument is insulated except for the small portion of the hook which carries the cautery current. The advantage of laparoscopic surgery is that the patient is very comfortable after the surgery. The pain is very less. Now as you can see, the cyst wall is almost separated except for a very small attachment on its lower surface. So the final bits of cauterization is being done so that the cyst can be separated completely from the main pedicle. The patient had actually presented to us with abdominal pain on and off. Patient had history of vomiting, but there was no history of fever. On investigations on CT scan, this was the mesenteric cyst of 5 cm which was found, which was attached to the intestines, and it had the same blood supply as well. So this is a unique case in which we tackled it laparoscopically. The patient was post-operatively, patient was started on oral liquids after 2 hours, and solid diet was started after 3-3.5 hours. The patient was discharged after 36 hours of the surgery. The patient was very comfortable after the surgery and did not require much of painkillers in the post-operative period. Only a single shot of antibiotic was given pre-operatively, and no other antibiotic courses were repeated later. Patient had followed up after a week for the stitch removal, and the wound had healed without any infection. The histopath of this showed a benign character of the cyst wall. So now as you can see, the final bit of the attachment of the cyst is remaining, which is again being tackled by the hook. So this is a cautery which is used to burn off the blood vessels so there is no bleeding. So the final bit is remaining. This is a cyst wall which is finally attached. The final bit is remaining. So then the cyst wall is completely separated from the rest of these structures. Now to remove the cyst, we need to put an endo bag. So that is what is being put. And the cyst is then introduced inside the endo bag. And this is decompressed inside the bag so that there is no spillage of the contents in the rest of the peritoneal cavity. A small needle is introduced inside so that we can decompress the whole cyst, and only the cyst wall can be removed later on very easily with a small 5 mm incision. The bag ensures that there is no spillage of the contents. Secondly, all the contents and the cyst wall are removed completely. So now, as you can see, the cyst is completely decompressed and then it is being extracted through the endo bag. Thank you.